Hi, John 13:45. He who sees me sees him who sent me. These are the words of our Lord and God, Savior Jesus Christ. He is the Word of God and was God himself in the flesh, who did come into this world and dwelt among us. It says so. It says in 1 John 5:7 that in heaven three bear witness as one. That is the Father, the Word, and the Holy Spirit. They are one, and they bear witness as one. That means one God. Who is God? God Jehovah. Well, if they all three bear witness as one, then that means that Jesus Christ is God too, and the Holy Spirit. So therefore, they are one God alone, but yet three separate in the presence as one God alone still, and infinitely. Throughout infinity, they have always existed. It has nothing to do with you or me or anyone on this planet who has ever been here or ever created, ever, up until the return of God Jesus. It's all God's plan. Jesus Christ said, we will create man. We will create the world first, and then man and animals and land and the fish and the birds and the sea and everything that dwells within it now, as well as everything around this earth and everyone in heaven or all in heaven. That means all of his beautiful angels. No one can be concerned about anything more except for this. Be well in your heart about who Jesus Christ is as God alone, with God Jehovah and God the Holy Spirit. Yes, I do say they are one God because they are. There is proof in the Bible where God taught it. He wrote it with his disciples. Through the Holy Spirit, they heard God's word come into their heart from God Jesus to the Holy Spirit, who is God too. And they heard those words and they wrote them down. Why? Because we now have the Bible. It's all bundled up together in many books, the Old Testament and the New Testament. Now we know that Jesus Christ gave us his word, the Bible alone, that teaches us who he was and who he is, our God and Savior. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. No man in pure flesh alone can die on the cross for any sin. Only Jesus Christ, our God and Savior. He was God himself in the flesh, in the body, but God in spirit. So just remember that whenever anyone says to you that you are wrong or someone is wrong when they say Jesus Christ was man himself in the flesh, but God in spirit was what I meant to say earlier. He's God himself in the flesh, meaning he's man in the flesh, but God in spirit. That means he testified who he was when he was here. Yes, he was born of a virgin, his mother called Mary. There's nothing wrong with any of that. The Holy Spirit enveloped her and she became pregnant with our God and Savior Jesus. There is nothing wrong with this. It's pure, it's holy, and it's right and righteous. Why? Because God Jehovah and God Jesus said so. They are God. Who knows more than God? Do you? I wouldn't think so. No one does. They did what was right and righteous and pure and holy before who they were as God alone, in three in the separate presence as one God alone. They bear witness for each other and for each other as one God, but the three in presence of who they are is by name, God Jehovah the Father, God Jesus the Word, and God the Holy Spirit, who is the holiness of who they all are too, in spirit. But at the same time, when he came here on this world, in this earth with us, he was a man, a baby, born from the womb of a woman here. Now that makes him still flesh, but he had the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God, Jehovah was with him. So he grew into a man and he fulfilled his purpose, his work here on this planet. Know this, he is God and God alone. No one can be God, no one can be a God, and if you have a faith or a religion that eliminates God in your life, or eliminates Jesus Christ as God and God the Holy Spirit as one God with God Jehovah in the presence of three, get out of that faith and get out of that religion. Start praying and asking God Jesus to show you more in the Bible. If you have a religion that teaches outside of the Bible, just remember this, in Revelation, you cannot use another book to teach as a Bible. The Bible is the Word of God alone. He wrote it, and that's it. In Revelation 22:18-19, it will say that if you read and write another book outside of the Bible in the format of teaching it as a Bible, well, you will be punished for that. It's God's Word. You cannot add to God's Word or take away from God's Word. And when you are in God's Word, if you have a faith that studies the Bible all the time, and they have scriptures that say that Jesus Christ was not God, then they are lying to themselves. And that's a shame, because God's word is the holiness of who he is and was when he was here as a man, but God himself in the flesh or in spirit. Remember that nobody can do what God Jesus did. They are God alone, God Jehovah, God Jesus, and God the Holy Spirit. I will teach this. I will preach this. I will say that my life depends on this, and so does yours. It's all in the Bible. Many times it says Jesus Christ is God. Read the Bible daily. Ask God to help you to understand the Bible better daily. He's in your heart now. That's the Holy Spirit, who is God too. He's with all on this planet right now. Regardless if you doubt God or Jesus Christ as God, he's still with us. The Holy Spirit, God, is still with us right up until the end of time on this planet. Now, once God Jesus returns, that's it. He'll be gone from this earth forever. Do you want to remain here forever, or do you want to be in heaven forever? Whew, that's not a tough question for me to answer. I want to be home with Jesus Christ, our God and Savior, forever. This world is finished in God's sight. It's done. It's over. He's not happy with it anymore. More people on this world right now deny God than ever. Get into your heart. Get on your knees before God. Beg for his forgiveness of your sins. Ask forgiveness of your sins. He will forgive you. Ask him to put your name in the book of eternal life, to write it there and never erase it. Worship him daily as God Jesus alone, and be there with him in your life to teach others about who Jesus Christ is as God alone. Say his name when you pray. When you pray and ask anything in a prayer, finish it with, I pray and ask this in Jesus Christ, God's name. That's his name. I pray that everybody in church who teaches a sermon will start saying Jesus Christ is God with God Jehovah and God the Holy Spirit. People in church don't necessarily know that Jesus Christ was God. How do I know this? Because I've been to churches and I've talked to people, and people have said they have denied Jesus Christ as God. And this is in a church that's non-denominational. So you have to know that when the pastor is speaking, he has to be saying Jesus Christ is God with God Jehovah and God the Holy Spirit as one God. But three presences, not three persons, not three spirits, and not three entities. They are separate in presence of three. They are presence. They are in the presence of three, of one God alone still. How do I know this? I prayed and I asked God, Jesus, to help me to understand how to say this. Not the Trinity, not three persons, not three entities, not three spirits. He said, presence, honey, presence. Yes, my God, Jesus, calls me honey. I love him, and I call him my God and my Savior and my Creator forever. I pray you will too. Don't forget these things that God is teaching me and has taught me. I'm teaching you because that's what God wants. He wants us to be his student and to be students of the Word, and then to become teachers for people around us who are just babes in the Word of God. Remember that Jesus Christ is God with God Jehovah and God the Holy Spirit. One God, three in the presence, as one God alone still, infinitely, always, and infinitely still. God bless.